Cool. So. Today we're gonna play some Fear. Fear is a first-person shooter that's got, like, horror elements and stuff like that. And it's a very fun game. Like, if you're into shooters, this is, like, a classic sort of really good shooting game. Like, it's just, I don't know. I've always found it extremely fun playing it. And it does have horror elements and a story and stuff, and it's all alright. This is still probably the best game in the entire series. Especially, 2 and 3 existing. Especially 3. Anyway, we're gonna be starting a new game on extreme difficulty because I'm a masochistic player, apparently, according to the bottom down here. So we'll start that off, and, we'll see where we get to. I'm not going to play it for a ton of time. I'm going to play it for maybe an hour and a half or something like that. And then we'll move over to Zelda Randomized, which I've managed to fix as well. So let's get started. I can't remember if this progresses before I can read it or not on this screen. The situation is a high-level alert has been issued, and our mission is, as part of the FEAR team, to report for emergency briefing on the situation. I still find it stupid that they decided to call a organization within the government FEAR, you know? And we're going to get a couple of cutscenes here to start off with, so it's going to build up some story. And tell us about our mission. That's still such a stupid name. First Encounter Assault Recon. Just so they can have the acronym of FEAR. But this game is great. It's a lot of fun. I can't wait to play it. We're going to get a tutorial level very fast. That was weird. I don't know if that... I feel like this FMV here should be at full screen, but it's not. It keeps switching resolutions. This is the subtitle size we'll be looking at, by the way. These previews we're seeing here. The man himself. Giving him a good old punch. You know, this game's not as bad looking as I thought it might be. I thought it'd look a lot crustier. I still think the blood effects in this game though are like some of the best. Like, available.
Yes?
Sorry to wake you, Senator. It's about Origin.
What happened?
There was an uprising. Fettel has taken command of the prototypes.
My God.
We can still resolve this discreetly, but we have to move fast.
Oh, all right. Let me make a few calls.
This wacko's name is Paxton Fettel. He's the key. If we contain him, we contain the situation.
Fucker's got an appetite.
I think he has an agenda. It's not just recreational. He's getting something out of it.
Essential vitamins and nutrients?
What's his story?
Property of Armacam Technology Corporation. They're working on a military contract to develop an army of clones that respond to a psychic commander. Top secret, of course. Fettel is one of the commanders.
You gotta be fucking kidding me. This is why nobody takes us seriously. Military clones?
A full battalion of them. Highly trained and heavily armed.
A battalion? What are we supposed to do against 1,000 super soldiers?
Like I said, we put Fettel down and it's over. Fortunately, the whole point of the program is to give commanders first-hand knowledge of the battlefield without putting them in danger. That means we should be able to corner the bastard without having to wade through all those soldiers.
How do we find him?
Army camp implanted a transmitter in his head. Should lead us right to him.
That's awfully convenient.
Assuming it does what it's supposed to. What about you, buddy? Ready to go to work?
You're putting him in the field? Are you crazy? He just transferred in a week ago.
You've seen his training results. His reflexes are totally off the charts. I think he can handle himself.
Whatever, man. It's your call.
Goddamn right it is.
Don't worry. You'll be fine.
Let's roll.
What's the first thing you remember?
Oh yeah, all these scenes.
You will be a god among men.
Forgot about all these scenes.
We've tracked Fettel to an abandoned building just up ahead. No sign of enemy activity on the satellite, but don't take any chances.
Okay.
Jankowski, you in position?
Just say the word.
All right, move it out.
So, mission is to go and find Paxton Fettel, which is the nice fellow we saw at the beginning of the game. He had a bit of strawberry jam on his face. He was eating that guy's lunch that you saw earlier. Yeah, the guy was complaining that no one takes our team seriously. Would you take a team seriously that's called Fear? Like, it sounds like a ghost hunting team. Anyway, let me just quickly adjust the head bob, which is massively over the top for some reason. That should be better. Oh yeah, it's better. So this is a really fun game in general. Like, I love like the mechanics that are in this game. The gunplay feels great. The melee system is hilarious. Like, we've got a roundhouse kick, for example. We got like just basic melee, but we've got a roundhouse kick. We've got a flying kick that we can do as well. And the good old slide tackle. If you can remember how to do that, that's there we go. It's a lot of fun. There's like a lot of fun mechanics. You can even just go unarmed and just punch things. It's pretty great. And there is the abilities, there's a slow-mo ability we can use as well. Why is tab open doors? Not sure I like that. I did not set tab to be open door. Apparently I did. Okay. Well, let's change this back to F then. And then for melee, we're gonna have to do like mouse button 2. Let's see how that works. Yeah, it's fine. Cool. So this is a game I didn't play much when it initially came out, because the laptop I had could not run this game at all. So I played it a load when it came out on the Xbox 360 finally. And it was a lot of fun. I really enjoyed it.
Hey bro, what took you so long? Try to find a way around.
Okay. There's like so many wacky physics in this game as well. Like, most objects can be pushed around by even rats. Just like the rat just threw his chair into the air, for example. Anyway, if I remember, there is a thing here for us to collect somewhere. There it is. Health booster. What, there was something down there for a second. Anyway, there's going to be health boosters and reflex boosters that we can find throughout the game. They'll fill up our health, or they will increase our maximum health as well. They can also increase our maximum reflex time. Our reflex time is when we go into slow motion here, like so. And we can use it at any time, as long as we've got it available to us. And you can combine shooting and melee attacks and stuff like that. And just to warn you, this game's going to be full of spooky moments and jump scares and stuff like that, so just be aware of that. We are going to get musical stings like that. Very loud musical stings. This game at the time was really good because, like, there wasn't many games that did this sort of thing, like, scary sort of shooter in this sort of way. They did a lot of, like, good physics stuff. And the lighting as well. They did a lot of good dynamic lighting. You know what? I don't like... Forgot about that. I don't like how I've got the melee at the moment. I'm gonna have to switch that back. I'll have to find something else for use. because I don't like it on the middle mouse, you know? Interaction, let's put melee back on F. And then we'll put use on... I guess I'll just put it on tab again. Unfortunately, I can't customize the controls as much as I would like on this, but come on. It just is how it is. Just gonna take some getting used to. I'm ready. Go. He's disintegrating.
You were born here, in this place. I was there.
You get a lot of hallucinations in this game as well and stuff. This guy.
Jin, we need you up here.
On my way.
And now he's back.
Looks like we're too late, boss. Just leftovers.
The transmitter signal's coming from nearby. It's gotta be around there somewhere.
I'll wait here for Jin. You take a look around.
I thought the flashlight lasted a little bit longer than this, but apparently not. Ooh, there he was. Now, I remember on the Xbox 360 version of this game, there was like some stupid achievements for taking out like 5 crows and 5 rats and stuff like that. They were like anti-achievements. I think they were like classed as fake achievements. Just ones that were like, gave you 0 points on the Xbox and they would just be there, you know, forever. Oh, I thought it flew out the window for a second. I love the physics on this game. I kind of wish they kept just building off of this game instead of what they did with Fear 2 and 3. But I think they were done by different studios, those games. I don't know. And I didn't do my usual thing there. I usually like to fly kick past that.
The dead man's name was Childers Haberger. I remember him, but are the memories mine or hers? It makes no difference. He deserved to die. They all deserve to die.
Come in, over. What's going on? I've lost Fettel signal.
Comcast, this is Dead Mother. I hope you aren't busy. We've got a situation down at the harbor.
What kind of situation?
We located those soldiers you were looking for, but we're under orders not to engage until you guys reconnoiter.
Understood.
I've got 2 birds en route to your position. You should have a visual shortly.
We'll be ready.
So there is a lot of vagueness in this game early on. We'll learn more about, you know, Paxton Fettel there and what he's talking about later. It might be a little while, though. This game is decent length, actually. There is the expansions to it as well. I don't know when I'll do the expansions exactly. But the expansions are... they're decent. The extraction point's really good. And then Perseus Mandate is kind of eh. But it's got, you know, it's still fun gameplay-wise. Apparently, both expansions aren't canon either, which makes no sense.
What do you think of the new point, man? Hey, back already? See anything?
Oh, I'll go away. You guys are talking about me.
You boys run along. I'll be busy here for a while.
I don't want to go. I want to know what you're doing. I want you to tell me about him.
Come on, make a push.
I've tried to forget. I've tried so hard to forget.
These men are from Fear. They are special attachments to our unit for the duration of this op. They will be on point. Their mission is to assess the nature of the threat. Our job is to keep them alive. Do not engage the enemy. Remember that we are not dealing with ordinary bad guys. Team 1 will move in from the southwest. Team 2 will approach from the north. Once our recon is complete, we will rendezvous and wait for further orders. Okay, let's saddle up.
Well, I can't wait. We're going to get into combat pretty soon. Yeah, first part is just a tutorial mission, more or less, just so you get used to the controls. Nothing happens in it. Most of what's going to happen is going to start in this level, where we get to start doing some fighting. So, basically, the situation is Fettel is apparently, you know, alluded to be like this psychic soldier guy. He's controlling all these clones that they've been making for these psychic controllers to, you know, command in battle and stuff, or into these sort of situations, or whatever, replica force, they do things. And they're up in this wastement treatment plant, so we're going there to investigate. I just felt like all of the, I always feel like all of the places this game is based in always looks like just nothing but docks. The entire game looks like this, for some reason.
Since you're on point, see if you can get this gate open. I'd send one of my boys. But I think we need a specialist for this one.
This guy's such a, like, a cock. He's just always like, we need a specialist to open this door for us. And here's a reflex booster over here. That's gonna increase our time we can stay in slow-mo. Nothing in here. I don't think they added melee doors until like one of the expansions, but you could melee doors in one of them to open them up. Unless I'm thinking of a different game. Pretty sure I'm thinking of this one though. Oh yeah, the spinny chair. Chair spins. Okay, let's open the gate for these guys. There we go. What's happened? That's a big mess. I've always loved that skeleton shot at the end of this cutscene. I don't know why, just the skeleton falling over at the end is just comical to me. Yeah, it's our squad though. Didn't stand a chance against that little girl. I've got to do this. I love doing this. I just love the physics so much in this game, and what you can do with like the melees and stuff. The entire skeleton just flies across the room when you kick it. It's like amazing. Nope, glass smash. It has been a while since I last actually played through this game as well, so some of it I don't remember. But...
I started shooting.
We're gonna run into our first bad guys. Maybe this is where it gets fun. The game becomes very action orientated and it's like a lot of fun. The it's so cinematic as well with all the like dust and debris flying all over the place, bullet holes, etc. Whose blood's that? Is that mine? I thought it was something in here. Just the mystical sting there. Ooh, medkit. So medkits are going to be very important to us because we don't really have a way to recover health. This is before all the regenerating health and stuff took off in games. Because, I don't know. I kind of like, always liked having a health system rather than a regenerating system, personally. It makes you think about your attacks and moves more in games and like how you tackle certain situations. You're not always gonna just run in and then hide behind cover and recover, you know, after that. There's a sound glitch here. It's weird. I remember thinking that you could only melee these when I was first playing this. But you can just shoot any boards off that you need to. There is some mods for this that improve some of the guns as well. One of them actually makes it so this gun doesn't fire in bursts when you fire. Because it fires in bursts every single time you press like the fire button once. It's kind of annoying. I love this game. It's so good. The AI is a lot of fun as well. The AI is very simple, but how they made AI work makes it really fun to play against, because AI will flank you and do some like crazy things. And you'll hear him communicating and stuff, it's just like, very immersive. Oh, we got the double pistols. It's great because it's very John Woo inspired, this game, with like how the shooting works and everything. They took a lot of inspiration from like all the John Woo sort of movies and stuff. And it makes it very fun, you know, just, it's cinematic and fun. And over the top in a lot of fighting situations. I'm grabbing all this ammo from these guys. I don't think there's any more enemies around here. We're okay for health and armor at the moment. I was delaying using my slow-mo quite often there. There are certain boxes, I think, later on that you can break for some more goodies, but, don't think it's anytime soon. Oh, yeah, there's a big bet. Ooh. Something crazy happening in the distance. So we want to go up here and grab this. So each one of those you grab, it increases your maximum health by 5, and I think you can go all the way up to 200, if I remember.
This is Echo 6. We've reached the first marker. Roger, Echo 6. Secure the area. Freeze out the
Overtop battle music. Oops. I keep trying to run on this game. I'm so used to having like a sprint button now. And I've set the sprint key to be slow-mo on this because there's no sprint. So I keep trying to sprint and it's just doing nothing. It's hilarious. I can't wait until we get some of the later weapons though. Some of the later weapons are so fun to use. What are you doing? I think there's two more guys in here as well.
Oh yeah. Oh.
Hey, back up. I have to be careful with situations like that. I turned off my slow-mo too early. No firearms or weapons on this property. I definitely need some more armor. That's his problem. I love the screams as well on this game. Just so slow down and over the top. Okay, so there's some goodies in this room I want. I just got a rifle. And you can pick up things by pressing an interact key or button. But if you walk over things, it collects them as well. Unless you've got free weapons. This is one of those games where, like, once you've got free weapons, you have to switch them out if you want something else. So, you won't walk over something and lose your weapon, for example. Okay. Let's answer this. Even the poster board here just like moves around. Anyway, we need to press this switch that'll move this container across and we'll be able to use it. I'm gonna save this rifle for later. There is some platforming moments in this game as well, but they're not too crazy. Look at that impact on that guy. And there's not much left of him after that. There is actually a mod that increases how much dismemberment there is in stuff in this game as well, but that seems a bit over the top. I chose not to mod this game at all. The only thing I did was I added a patch that made it so I could play it at like 1080p 60fps. And I think that was the only thing it did, more or less. It was like a community patch or something like that. But I didn't want to really mod it because this game is just good enough as it is. I didn't want to do much more to it. There we go. Medkit. We can only carry 4 medkits, so... Oh, I missed him. Uh oh, now they all know where I am. Just. I like how they're all just down there. looking up. Where are you? Yeah, on extreme difficulty. Uh-oh. Nope. You have to be careful as well, because on extreme difficulty, the enemies can do a ton of damage to you in, like, no time. There's not, like, any sort of invincibility frames or... Yeah, there's no sort of, like, invincibility frames or anything like that in this game. And you don't get any, like, moments of relief when you're getting shot up. Like you would in some other games. Whatever damage you take, it just, like, will keep, building onto you. So, you can easily lose all your health in, like, no time. Oh, this guy's leg came off from that grenade. Oh, I don't know if this is the same on the PC version or not. But in some situations like that, the bodies can't be moved, but their like dismembered leg or arm can. And the only way to kick the body or move the body around is by attacking the limb that's been detached. It's kind of weird. That made me jump. He made me jump then. <What's it? laughs> I like how he was just there. Now, one of the things that can happen with this game is when these guys are dying, they all keep firing. And that can easily kill you as well if you're too close to them as well. Because their stray bullets will hit you still, and you can die in situations like that. I'm going to try and find all of the boosters and stuff. If I could find them. If I can remember where they all are. There's like quite a lot. There's more than you can actually, you know, make use of. As far as boosters go and stuff. And there is some other things like collectibles, like phone messages and stuff like that in this game. They don't do anything on Steam, on the Steam version of the game, but if you play on the Xbox version or PlayStation version, they give you achievements if you find them all. So, if you're watching that, then you can do this. Actually, there's some pretty cool achievements on this game in the 360 version. There's like really challenging ones as well. There was somewhere like you had to beat the game with less than 500 bullets and stuff like that. There was some insane achievements they had to do. Oh no, it's Jankowski. Where are you going? Could do some more armor pretty soon. I don't think there's anything in this room. I think the sound design has been changed in this.
Is someone there?
No one's here but us skeletons. Yeah, I think the PC version overall has more audio mixing, or like audio elements put into it. I can't remember exactly. It definitely promotes exploring this game. So it's worth like exploring every now and then. When you see alternate pathways and stuff. You usually find some good stuff like weapons or ammo or, you know, grenades and boosters. They had a party in here, these guys. What else happens in this level? I don't think there's much more left of it. Oh yeah, it's this scene. I remember not knowing what to do on this scene the first time I played. So we've got this corridor exploding. And we can see a little girl down there. But all you have to do is run towards the window back there and it just throws you out of it. So that's all we gotta do. So, we're still in the same area. We're still looking around for Paxton here. He's somewhere around here somewhere. Apparently one operative has been found alive and the remaining operatives are still missing. And they're still tracking Fettel apparently, but we'll see. Might be able to find him here. He's still around this area.
He's alive.
Should I call in a medevac?
He doesn't appear to be injured, although I don't know how he survived.
Worry about that later. I'm reading Fettel's transmitter near that position. We gotta take that fucker out, fast. Jen, keep looking for Jankowski. I'm still reading his life signs.
You can't send him in alone, that's crazy.
He can take care of himself. Now move.
Be careful in there.
You're lucky to be alive.
You part of the Fear Squad? Or are you just someone else? There's a lot of situations like this, actually, in this game, when you hang around characters, they'll talk.
Don't you have work to do?
And say stuff like this. I'm pretty sure this guy says some more stuff. You wanna talk to me some more? Either of you? Gonna see my sweet moves. Well, they're not listening to me anymore. They're not paying attention to me. I know when I'm not wanted. Ooh. Spooky van. About to get a whole lot crazier this game. Oh, the blood's dripping off the table.
Looks that way. I'm a little short on detail. I guess this ain't a covert op anymore.
I thought the blood was dripping from the ceiling for a second there. There is going to be some big fights coming up here shortly. But it's, gonna be in a little while, yeah. You get a lot of this as well between fights, where you'd like, it's not really like puzzling or whatever, it's just kind of you're sort of trying to make your way through a building, or you're trying to make your way through like areas to access other areas and stuff. Look at this bottle. It has such a low texture bottle. Cool, there's that done. There's like some side stuff in some of the phone messages. Some of them are just like that though, where it's like people don't understand what the situation is. They don't know what all this noise is and stuff like that. While other parts will actually add bits of story to what you're hearing. Oh yeah, is this section I think it is? I am not a fan of this section. It's dark, it's a sewer. Bad things happen in sewers. Bad things happen to good people. There is a booster in the distance. Spooky shadows. And there's actually situations like this where your flashlight no longer works. there's like electrical interference in certain like segments and situations, and you'll see your HUD elements flickering and stuff like that. You'll see the flashlight flicker as well, and in some situations the flashlight just doesn't work anymore. There is a medkit down there. I think I'm still set to walk. Yeah, there we go. So weird pressing tab to use things. I think by default it was F. But... let's see if we can get him to say the thing. Yes! It did hit him. Oh, he dove. He dove through that window. I'm sad I missed that. That's the thing as well. There's explosive barrels and fire extinguishers and stuff you can shoot on this game as well, which will hurt or kill the enemies. Well, it'll distract them. The fire extinguishers like create like a dust cloud as well, like a CO2 cloud or whatever. Someone's like, wait, where's the rest of his body? Oh, it's there. Lash. Are you rushing or are you dragging? Come on, switch weapon. I'm gonna die. Yep, I'm gonna die. Maybe not. I was gonna die. But not anymore. Yeah, we do have a limit of 10 medkits, so we'll be using them often. Early on, you get a lot of medkits, and you don't have to worry too much about being sparing with them. Unless it's your first time playing, like, on, you know, whatever difficulty you're playing on. I find on, once you get to, like, I think below 25 health, it will recover you up to 25. But, I can't remember exactly. I might be thinking Doom 3 there. With all the boosters in this game as well, later on you won't really need this. That's so cool. What if I just like turned into like loads of gibs? Sorry, jibs. Flashlight. One of us heard me knock something over in the distance. You can walk on this game as well to be quieter. So it's something to note. Oh yeah, this segment. I managed to glitch out this segment once. Oh, didn't mean to do that. I didn't mean to activate my flashlight in front of them guys then. And I also didn't mean to run into him. I was trying to put my slow-mo on and press the wrong key. Okay, so we just need to do that fight again. Do that fight a little bit different this time. We're not going to see the AI doing a whole lot this early on yet, but soon they will be doing a whole lot more with their interactions with the environment and stuff and their tactics. They designed, like, a lot of areas later on and, well, later on in this level, I should say, to work with the AI better. And some of these small parts where there's only one or two enemies, these are just to get you used to, like, fighting enemies, so it's still technically like a tutorial level in a way, this game. I mean, this level. I really want a shotgun. Yeah, I really wanted to get the shotgun again. There's some other fun weapons later on that I want to show off. Somehow glitched out of the way then. That's kind of weird. Actually, I need to double check something. I don't think there is anything down here, but I don't want to miss out on... Oh yeah, look, there is something. I didn't want to potentially miss out on something, and here we go. Reflex booster. In some situations as well, with the boosters, if you can do a fight where there's like a booster nearby or a reflex booster, well, either kind of booster, and you need it, it will instantly fill up your reflexes or your health, so it's really handy to somehow work those into your play style sometimes. It doesn't matter so much in the campaign on this. If you've got the Xbox version or whatever, though, there's like a mode called Instant Action, which throws you straight into some like, it's like levels that are made up of different segments of the game. There'll be like certain sections of each level that are put together, stitched together to make one bigger level. He punched me while I was in slow-mo. Oh yeah, the slow-mo isn't technically slow-mo. It's apparently your character, Point Man, is supposed to just be really fast. His reflexes are like really fast, so it's... So to everybody else, it looks like you're running really fast, but to him, you're just like in slow motion. Ooh, that was painful. Okay, let's not do the bad thing again here. We are gonna get into some bigger fights still here. What is going on with his ragdoll? These ragdolls. Oh man. I'm having so much fun with this. I love this game. Like, this is probably one of my favorite shooters. At the very least, like, top three shooters. But, it's probably in my top 20 games of all time as well. Just like, it's just so much fun. I always have fun with this game. I can't remember if it was this place or a different place, but I remember glitching out in a vent once. It might have been an extraction point, actually. I don't remember. So yeah, having a flashlight on it does alert the enemies. They're smart enough to understand light. Oh yeah, laptops. The Alienware laptops. I forgot about this. It had like a integration with Alienware at the time when this game came out. And they were trying to promote Alienware inside of the game as the best laptop you could be using, or computer you could be using to play this game on.
The data's uploading now. Interesting. I found a wastewater analysis
I can't remember actually if in the console versions of this game if it had Alienware stuff in the game. Look how blocky this is. Yeah, I can't remember if the Alienware stuff was in the Xbox and PlayStation versions, but it's kind of funny that it was integrated into this. Okay, I'm full on health actually, this early on. Grab a couple of things. Look at this. This mouse pad here. That mouse. It's funny because like a lot of the equipment in the game looks like gaming stuff. Like obviously this PC doesn't, but like the mouse and mouse pad, for example, do. Obviously the Alienware laptops in the game, like a gaming related. There's some interesting things like that. I don't know where this lens flare is going from. You can, Excellent screw that doorway there. Oops. I kind of wish it was hold to aim to aim rather than, pressing the key to aim once. It's coming for me. I just saw him go around the corner. I don't think he knows where I am. This fighting is so much easier though on a PC than it is on the console version. I don't think there's any more ammo here in need. They got mainly SMGs at this point on this level. I think later on you mainly get this gun, the G2 rifle. But the SMG is usually the main thing you come across with the enemies, at least early on. There is full swimming in this game as well, by the way. There's not very many places where you do swim, but there's actually full swimming animations and stuff. It's pretty cool. It's just kind of like one of those extra details they didn't need to do in the game. But your guy does like paddle and stuff. Like swing his arms while swimming. I'm just gonna use up my medkit, top of my health, and grab that one. I don't need it otherwise. Another one of these bottles. Actually, what does it say on the bottle? Old rum? Old bum? It's 40 ounce. Apparently, it doesn't break the bottle when I do that. There is fall damage in this game, but a drop like this is not high enough to hurt you. Yeah, the lighting on this game actually really makes this game a lot. The dynamic lighting. Definitely adds to the atmosphere on this one. Alright, let's jump down. Yeah, this fun cutscene. This hallucination. Here he is! I don't think I have a flashlight in that scene, but there's a big skeleton that jumps out of the blood and gets you. So, situation here, we're basically still looking around for Fettel. But, we're engaged with replica people. They're all fighting us now. And, they positively identified Charles Heberger, which is what Beto was talking about in that first level. We still need to find him, though, and we need to find out the enemy objective in the area.
Jen, any word on Jankowski?
No, but I found his human remains. It crossed over the rest of the
Southwest. It can't be him. His life signs are a little unusual, but he's definitely alive. He's got to be around there somewhere.
I'll keep looking.
That's kind of cool. Light in here. There is another med kit. I'm really not in need of med kits, or armor really at the moment. I do remember this game being a lot more difficult, but maybe it's because I played it so much on the Xbox, it doesn't even matter. Like, I played it so much on the Xbox that it probably just feels really easy now I'm used to playing on PC. We do have a guy in here though. Just sort of watching the monitors. His cameras went offline. Oh, he's moving. What are you doing? Are you definitely dead? I think now he's definitely dead. This is a pretty cool room here.
She's afraid of you.
That made me jump. I completely forgot about that as well. I think we're about to get into a fight around here as well. There's some armor down there and another medkit. I'll keep that in mind. I think someone was throwing a grenade, but I don't know who. Oh, he's above me. But there was a achievement for beating this game without using slow-mo on the Xbox, which is really difficult. This game without slow-mo is really hard to beat. Because the slow-mo on this game is like such a necessary tool on the higher difficulties. Because you will lose health in absolutely no time without slow-mo. Is there anything back this way? It glimpses of the outside occasionally. Yeah, there's nothing else back this way. It just loops her back around. I want to... There's nothing in the water down here, I don't think. I do need to pick up that armor that we saw earlier. Should be in this room. Yeah. Back up to full med kits again. I think something that really makes this game as well with the combat is the replica soldiers themselves, because just their communication and yelling and stuff. He's just great. It's just hilarious. more armor here, and we've got a phone message.
You have one new message.
Hey man, I heard something crazy is happening over there. You alright? Let me know. We're still on for Friday, right? Call me back, bro. I hope you're alright.
End of messages.
It's kind of a sad message, that one. So mainly using the SMG at the moment because we've got so much ammo for it. This the G2 rifle's infinitely better, but I do want to just use up ammo on the SMG for now. Oh yeah, I just looked back around. You do occasionally just see these cans stood around on top of barrels and stuff, like someone's just been there, had a drink and just left it behind. Whether it's a soldier or the workers or what, you know. It's kind of a cool little detail. Makes the world feel a little bit lived in. I tried to press the tab to use my slow-mo then. That might be too low. Oh god. You can do some segments like kind of stealthily, take out a few enemies without them noticing with melee attacks. But yeah, this part is kind of rough. Nothing beats the feeling like of going slow-mo and just taking out all the enemies like that. I took some damage there. On the higher difficulties, the enemies will be a little bit faster with their aiming while you're in slow-mo. And occasionally they'll be able to hit you quite often. Just make sure there's nothing else around here to pick up. Nothing at all. Nothing good at all. I don't think there's any, I don't know why, but I thought we got a shotgun off of one of these guys at this part. I think it's the next fight.
Oh, shit. Copy?
Where is he? Oh, I saw him. Who's up on the walkway? There he is. They will, like, hear grenades being thrown as well, the enemies. It's kind of weird. Wait, have you got a shotgun? No. Excuse me? Oh, he's got a shotgun. Get rid of. Let's get rid of the SMG. I prefer the rifle over the SMG. There is an ammo exploit actually in this game. I've shown it off before on my channel when I played it on the Xbox. You can do something to get more ammo if you're desperate for it. Using what's available to you here, but I'm not going to show it off because it's kind of stupid, and you know, it kind of makes the game easy if you know how to do it, but I'm not going to do it. It's something I just discovered one day while I was playing Instant Action on the Xbox, so. Okay, so we've got this segment here where we need to fill up this area with some more water so we can get across. You're supposed to jump down and go on the ladder, and I've just kind of not done that. I'm actually walking on this ledge somehow. You're supposed to climb up this ladder and come up this way. Oh, there was some armor back there. Nice. I'd love to shotgun this game.
An explosion that leveled a dockside warehouse this evening was most likely the result of an industrial accident. No injuries have been reported, but emergency workers are still on the scene.
I don't think there's any more enemies to fight. So I'll fill up the water now. Back in that other room. Like so. And now we can jump across those boxes to get into the other area. It's kind of basic, but I appreciate that sort of thing in this game. They're going to send someone over here now to come and find me. I have to put the flashlight on. But it should be. Someone in the distance over there. Don't do that. Shotgun is so over the top and extra in this game. So much dust being kicked up from it. Just going down the stairs over here. Got it. I don't think there's a point to going up the stairs. Oh yeah, it takes you both to the same room anyway. Let's go upstairs. I think there's like a med kit up this way or something that we can get access to. Look at all these floodlights. Yeah, I was right. Some med kits and oh yeah, the proximity mines. These are fun to use. Toss one out. Oh, his head came off. The other guy stepped on the mine when it, like, became active. Switch back to grenades for now. Yeah, his head came clean off. This is a mature rated game. I forgot to mention. Oh! I didn't think there was anyone left. Oh, yes. This guy up here. Is that going to hit him directly? Oh, missed. Whoa. That's what I'm talking about. Looks like I'm just crumpled up in there. I think actually down there is a death pit if you fall down it. Heal up a bit more. Oh, this guy. There we go. Heavy guys. So this is going to be a new guy to deal with. And he's brought us a very nice weapon that I love a lot. The Penetrator. Let's have some fun with that. gonna shove him down the pit. As much as like carrying around the double pistols, like these free weapons are like the main weapons you probably will end up using. But I do like pick up the pistols from time to time because they're just fun to use. I don't think there's really a bad weapon in this game, off the top of my head. There is the machine pistols in the Xbox version, which are kind of fun to use, but they're not like good. So you're not missing much on the PC version without those, and I think there's a mod that adds those in, you know.
Shit, looks like these fuckers are pulling out. I'm seeing a substantial mobilization on the satellite.
Apparently they're pulling out. Yeah, I forget what the machine pistols are based off of for the guns themselves, but like I said, they're not great. They are fun to use here and there, but they don't beat the actual regular pistols. Regular pistols are just like so much fun to use. Add some style to the game, you know. But you can actually just skip this area by climbing up there, but we're not gonna do that. Oh, it's this segment. There's some environmental things like that that you can activate as well. Oh, I got him. Got him with a penetrator. The only problem with that fire being there now is it's kind of a pain for us to get around there, but it is what it is. Let's see. Yeah. No, you can't get inside there. We have to carry on this way. Climb up here. Checkpoint. And then we've got to activate this to raise the water level? Yeah. Because then that will allow us to get into that area. And this will take us back over here. If we can find another penetrator. And some more armor. I don't think there's anything else. Oh yeah, there is. I think you can use this area here to jump back down here if you need to, for some reason. Oh, when you've got a penetrator rack in your hands, you actually move a little bit slower. It's counted as like a heavy weapon. It's not very much, but like you move it just a small bit, just a tiny bit slower, you know. I was having some trouble there. There we go. Don't remember exactly how you're supposed to do that normally, but it was kind of being weird. Probably because, maybe it's like frame rate or something that's like doing that, I don't know. Oh yeah, here's our handiwork. This was the guy we hit with a penetrator. I don't exactly know where we hit him on his body with the penetrator, but he's like stuck up here now. Oh, there it is. Look, it went through his abdomen. It's like just dangling him there, though. That is a weapon I appreciate because it's just so much fun. Are you so. Oh.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Some secrets get buried deeper than others, but I know where to dig.
No, wait! You've got the wrong guy!
Hush now, Mr. Moody. The time for talk is done.
Please! No!
Rip, Mr. Moody. He's gonna have some intimate time with Paxton there. I don't think she can actually hurt you there. But I've always shot her just to be on the safe side. I think this is the end of the level. Yeah. So, we're still in the treatment plant. We're still searching. This is a big treatment plant. But, yeah. We've still not found Fel. And that's who we're still trying to find. We're going to eliminate him. This is where the game starts getting a bit crazier. With some of the stuff that happens. Gonna get a lot more hallucinations now as we go deeper into the game. Would be interesting if they did it this like a Eternal Darkness system. Eternal Darkness has like a
explosion in the harbor this evening may not have been an accident. We have learned that evidence of a fierce gun battle has been found by police investigators. Several bodies were recovered from the scene with bullet and shrapnel wounds. So far, no one is commenting on exactly what happened here or why.
The, yeah, you'll hear these radio broadcasts occasionally in this level. Just talking about the situation here. They're trying to work out stuff. It's kind of interesting that they sent police to this area with, what's going on. You know, it's kind of, not really a place. Why has this guy got grenades and a shotgun? It's like a worker. Anyway, hello, Mr. Rat. There is a booster in there. We'll get to that later, though. Yeah, the radio broadcasts just have the people trying to work out the situation. And like I was saying, it's kind of weird that they're trying to send police into this area during this time. The police would get destroyed by the replicas or, like, all the supernatural stuff going on. I never see what happens there. Like, I always see the thing. I always forget, like, there's something that appears in this room. And I always miss it.
You have one new message. First message from
Ian Hives. Hi, Bill. It's Ian Hives. Look, I just got your email. I wish I could give you some more background on this, but it's strictly need to know. Hell, I don't even know what all this is for. For now, look, just focus on the specific contaminants in the task summary. Maybe I can fill you in a little more once we complete the survey.
End of messages.
Blood room. Something's been sucked up into that vent. It's probably Bill. But yeah, whatever appears in that corner, I've never seen it clearly enough to work out what it is. It's probably Paxton. But, I don't know. I think we need to go down here for that booster. Down this dark hallway. I wonder who this poor fellow was down here, though. And then again, with a booster. The boosters look like, you know, fancy syringes, so, probably doing something down there I shouldn't have been doing in the first place. Something in the water around here. How are you people all acting?
Reed! Come on, make a push!
These hallucinations get more insane like this.
Yeah.
will start seeing these beings as well. These ghost things that float around. Within hallucinations. They'll damage you if they touch you. I've never actually noticed that a door closes behind us. I thought it was this door ahead of us that slammed or something. Some more supernatural stuff in that area. If you can read the top corner, it tells you, like, what you're experiencing sometimes. It just said unknown origin just now for that. You can't really see anything, though. It's just, like, there for added effect.
Where is she?
Just a little bit of a callback to Fettel. Playing with this guy.
Fettel finds her. Origin.
What are we talking about? Who's Alma and what's Origin? All right, buddy, get moving. Fettel's gotta be close.
That arm's like bright for some reason. Gonna get a load of replicas coming in here now. Shotgun feels so good at this game. Ooh, something came up and hit him. Like, stuck behind this barrel here. So, a door open. This. I think someone's in there. Yep. The penetrator is just hilarious. I think this guy's like stuck like this. Yeah. I think the other guy was jumping over the rail. Yeah, he's over there. I've always loved a penetrator. I think it's always been one of my favorite weapons in any game. Keep trying to press the wrong keys to do different actions. He's on the move. You above me? Where'd that shotgun shell go? Okay. Okay. Just dust and echoes. Killed him. That's an intense little fight there in that corridor. You can't really move much and enemies are sort of pinning you up down there. There's not a whole lot of wiggle room. Especially when you're coming from both sides of you there. I forget if there's anything down here. I think you get up into that vent. This poor guy just had a pistol. Oh yeah. This vent will take you somewhere. I don't remember where exactly. You get little cool segments like this just to find some extra stuff. I have a penetrator. Awesome, remote bombs. The remote bombs are fun. I do enjoy the soundtrack as well, honestly. Like the ambient sound. Oh, he's got a penetrator. Oh. Oh, there's more. I'm gonna die. There's another guy back here. He's hitting a rail. Got him in the end, though. So many like hallways here that it could be in this section as well. This is where I picked up the armor, I think. Because I think this goes back into. Yeah. Okay, cool. I just like to make sure I've looped around and checked everywhere, you know. You never know when you're going to find some more goodies. Look at this. Another penetrator as well here. They definitely give you a lot of penetrator ammo on this level. Like, it's introduced and they give you plenty of ammo to use with it. Whether that's through enemy drops or, like, placed, like, ammo like that. But it's worth looking around and seeing if there's any more for it. If it's a weapon you enjoy, it's even better. If you do anything with this, no. Where's this actually taking me? Oh, that's where that guy jumped down behind me and tried to shoot me in the back. No, don't. The grenades detonate on impact, so, like, if they touch a person, it will just always detonate on impact. So you want to make sure you don't, get hit by one. Could have gotten really out of hand really fast. Hey, this guy's missing his legs. All the bodies here. Oh, there's his legs. I don't know why this guy's inside the box there. So that's probably your first real fight there, like, where it can get pretty intense. Is this the end of the level again? I think this is the end. Yeah. Some of these segments are small areas. This one here, the intervals are more like chapters of the game or acts. Kind of like how it is in Gears of War or some other games. You got like acts structured or whatever. So interval 3 is a whole chapter or whatever. And the subtitled level is just like what that level is. We're still trying to get Paxton.
Tomcat, this is Dead Mother. I know you guys are hurting, but we could really use your help with this army camp situation. I just lost contact with my recon team, and the brass wants me to send in more men, which I'm reluctant to do until I know what we're dealing with in there.
My orders are to secure this guy, Fettel. Getting rid of him will break his telepathic link to the soldiers. Once they no longer have an objective, he should shut down.
That sure would be nice.
Tell you what, spare a chopper? Looks like a full-scale withdrawal. My gut tells me Fettel's on his way to Armor Camp, so maybe we can help each other out.
Can do.
I don't remember who Shepard is. He's the guy who's talking to our leader there. But, I think he's part of the, a team we'll see later on. I don't know. He's placing mines. We can get past the mines by shooting them. But if we step on those, we like die instantly, I'm pretty sure. We'll try not to step on them. I just landed on something and it gave me ammo. Oh, I got penetrator ammo. That's what it was. I heard someone move to my right. I miss having a pistol. Maybe I should toss out this for it. Kinda doesn't make sense for me to be carrying three big weapons anyway like this. I'll take the pistol. There's enough pistols in this game that you'll come across, you know, double pistols quite quickly, so. I'll hold on to that. The penetrator is powerful enough to be our main, like, shooting weapon anyway. Now, if you remember, if you shoot this, it causes that to happen. Which doesn't let you pass. If you step into that, you just, like, instantly fry, so. Oh, yeah, like that. I had full health anyway, I couldn't pick up that medkit.
Shit, I just lost Jankowski's signal.
Maybe his gear got damaged.
Maybe.
The fire and rescue guys are here. Once they've got the fire under control, we can check the rubble.
Let them handle it. I need you on standby to head inside our base as soon as the site is secure.
Roger.
Jankowski's not going to be found, I don't think. There's an enemy we won't see for a while, but it's a little preview of one that we're going to see later. Yeah, I'm going to say I think this is a fighting area. So a thing you can do with this game as well, when you shoot an enemy who's not aware of your position, you'll instantly kill them. You get that in some games, but this game does that as well. So that guy instantly died even though I just like barely hit him with a shotgun, that first guy. And it's because he didn't know where I was, this one. And if you can do that, in other segments, you will instantly kill the enemies. I think there's actually something up there that we want before we go up that giant ladder back there. I think there's like a booster or something? I don't quite remember. I mean, this is where that thing jumped down and ran off in this spot. Oh yeah, there's a booster, cool. Saves me using a medkit. My computer is going weird. Physics in this game sometimes. It's like they get magnetized to you, some of the objects, so like your hitbox is slightly bigger than your character, so like some of the objects just like react weirdly when you're near them, when it doesn't seem like they should be reacting. It's kind of funny sometimes though. We need to go back this way. If we fall down there, it's a death pit. Climb our way up here. Now we're on the other side of this doorway. We need to go inside that door there, so there's a power switch here? Yeah. Switch that off and now we can get through. They also grab that medkit now. that magazine? Want to look at the magazine? Event Horizon found. Okay. And another Alienware laptop.
All right, it's uploading. Remember that wastewater report I mentioned? There's a little more info here. The contamination seems to originate in the Auburn area. That place is practically deserted nowadays. Probably not a coincidence.
Probably not. I don't think you can actually attack the laptop. No. The laptop's... These... Oh! No, you can hit them. Okay. I was gonna say, I think they're, like, invincible, so you can't destroy them. Kind of like in certain games where, like, you know, a car that's, like, been paid to be put in the game can't be damaged. Like in the Dodge... I think there's a Dodge car in Rainbow Six Vegas that you can't damage in any sort of way. That's what I get reminded of. Yeah, this, I thought it was going to be one of those situations where you can't damage it in any sort of way because it's been put in there for branding purposes. Ooh. Yup. Let's grab this thing. We won't use this thing very often in this game. This is the ASP rifle. It's kind of like a sniper rifle in a way. But it fires bursts. It's like burst fire. And it's pretty powerful. It's just... You don't really see it very often in this game, and there's better weapons, so this is probably the only time we get to use it, and that's why I picked it up. I think you can melee the locks off. Yeah, you can. So that's something you can do as well for the locks, so you don't have to use any bullets up when you are trying to beat this game with less than 500 bullets. Let's go down here.
We've lost contact with the search team.
There was a demo for this game that I played originally for the Xbox, and this segment was in that demo. Like this room. So the SP rifle's not going to be useful here, so I won't use it here. But... Oh, I got them both. Anybody else? No. It's a painful way to go. But yeah, that first shot I did with the shotgun took out both these guys instantly because they weren't aware of me. So if you're having a hard time like playing on the harder difficulties, that is a good tip for you, like taking the opportunity to take out several guys before they notice you. This would have been hard to do with melee, I think. Like, running up to both of them and meleeing them. But, using a weapon works really well there. Show off the ASP rifle real quick. Sorry for remote bombs that I've not used up, but, yeah, the ESP is really powerful, but it's just not overly useful in a lot of situations, honestly. Here comes the cowboy. You can shoot these guys as they'll jump out. So what happened there was I shot him And when he died, he dropped his gun. His gun, like, hit me. And because he had a shotgun, the shotgun shot at me when it hit the ground, and I was stood right on top of it as it hit the ground. So it, killed me. And I won't bother with the ASP this time. Let's continue with what we got. He's looking for me.
Target sighted.
Wow. It always surprises me when it happens with the shotgun. When you just shoot someone and just instantly evaporate. I love being able to do this. There's God, yeah, that guy just got eviscerated. This guy's head sort of dropped off. What else is there? There's not a whole lot of this like chapter left over. But I did want to get some Zelda in as well today. So I'll probably do a little bit more this level. We'll switch over to Zelda. These guys are drunk, apparently. I like his calendars just have a wrench. Off he goes. That guy actually glitched and dropped to the ground. Oh, still one more left. He's got a penetrator as well. Yeah, if you're quick on this segment, you can do what I did there and get him stuck in this area. Nice general area, and you can't get out to spread out. You could have come through his door here and engaged, but it's fine. That is the thing as well, if you put away your guns, I think you run faster? Maybe not. There's no more ammo here I need. There's a lot of explosive barrels in this place. Hurt by all the fire. One of these guys again. I shouldn't have rushed him. Just ran into his gun. Oh, I'm back here. A lot more of this level left than I thought there was, and the checkpoints are a bit fewer and far between I thought. I should use those remote bombs actually. I should have like tossed those up into that doorway area.
We've lost contact with the search team. Copy. I'm sending in reinforcements. You need to hold that.
I'm gonna find a search teams anymore. Come on out.
Yes, sir.
I missed him. Oh, that killed them both anyway, so. That's good. Someone's arm came off, someone's leg came off. It's a party down here. Did he see me? No. I thought he saw me because of the way he turned for a second. There's armor again down here. Again, if you like the SP rifle, it is good. It's just, I don't know. I feel like there's not enough opportunities to use the SP rifle. It's kind of funny is you can put a mine there after that guy blows the door open, and all the enemies will just drop down on top of it and just blow up instantly. Just toss a load of these up there. For later. These kill himself? Oh! I think the last guy shot the barrel in front of me. We'll do this section one more time, and if we die again, we'll switch games. I'm having a lot of fun with this. I'm glad I decided to play this game again. So I hope to, play all the way through this game and so I don't know where I was going with that trainer for. I'm not exactly sure where I was going with that trainer for. I don't know. I lost it either way. But I'm glad to be playing this game. I think I'll do the expansions at some point. Not sure if I'll do Fear 2. Fear 2 is okay. Some people like it more than like the expansions and stuff, and I think some people prefer it to this, but it's better than 3 of 3. I can tell you that for now. Like, straight away. Fear 3 is not great. Survived. Yeah, obviously did survive. I thought for a second his head came off, even though I was shooting his feet. This is like the first guy I kicked. That is painful. I think besides Halo 2, I think this was like one of the first games I saw actual ragdoll physics in, like, in this sort of way. But I also didn't play a whole lot of games during this period, like, when this game came out. As far as shooters went, anyway. So I'm gonna do the same thing again. I'm gonna toss up a load of, remote bombs up there to deal with, the heavy guy. And, hopefully I won't be killed instantly again. I'm gonna avoid that explosive barrel there. Oh, he's dead. Come and get me. Chase me, replica. Chase me. Nice. So, the heavy guy's gonna come through there. Oh, he didn't die from it. The other dude did. Now he's dead. Did that other guy manage to jump over the side before? Oh yeah, he did. Yeah. It's coming up. I think. It's walking to the left somewhere. Where are you going, friend? There we go. Running away from me like that. This guy right here. Stuck to the tool board.
Tomcat, this is Dust 7. I heard somebody needed a ride. Got an HLZ for me yet?
I'm showing a decent sized yard just ahead of my point man's current position. Only problem is there's an enemy gunship sitting there at the moment. I'll keep you advised.
Roger.
Oh, yeah, I am at the very end of the level because the chopper's going to come pick me up in a second, so I should be able to finish this off. There's a lot of empty cans around here. What is it actually in this game? Squish. And Fizzy. Fizzy Holo? Oh, Colo is spelled with a K. So I've even got a couple of open areas here to fight through. That'll take us to the end of the level. Yeah, let's use the assault rifle. I hope there's anything else in here, in this room. It's weird sometimes when you melee and then jump afterwards, you'll do like one of your other melee attacks. I seem to remember jumping through this. I can't seem to jump through it right now. There we go. Let's get this chopper here. And I remember this area really well because this was, like, an area for one of the instant action maps on the Xbox, and I played the hell out of instant action, trying to get, like, really good scores and stuff on it. You have to watch out for these guys tossing grenades out because the grenades have a habit of like locking onto you. Ooh, he came from a side. The greens have a habit of, like, locking onto you and, finding your exact spot at times. So, you definitely need to watch out for them. They're hard to... They're not, like, the easiest things to spot either sometimes when you're playing. With how fast-paced the game is without slow-mo, it is very hard to spot. Throw some mines out. Ooh, there's a grenade. Run. I kind of wish you could do the cinematic dive that you see in that segment where he was jumping out of the window earlier. Ugh. Someone else went and stepped on that mine I dropped. Where are you, friend? Maybe that was too heavy. What is that? He can take a lot of damage. His head was going berserk.
Looks like the HLZ is clear.
Gambi, I'm on approach.
Oh, that's the last fight. Is that the last fight?
Good. Head to ATC headquarters and find Fettel.
Yeah. I thought there was another like segment we had to do first before the helicopter came in. I think I played too much instant action on this like map. So that's the end of interval 3. So next time I'll do interval 4. And we'll save that for next time. Because interval 4 is going to be a whole other chapter that we don't want to be doing. It's going to take a lot more time. Let me find something here. Okay. I'll just check in something. Whoops. Oh, it quits the entire game. I thought it would take me back to the menu. Well, and in that case, yeah, I don't know. I expected it to take us back to the menu. I forget that you have to press leave game on that. Like it's a multiplayer game. It's kind of strange. Anyway, give me a moment here while I go ahead and get set up for Ocarina of Time.